Hi everyone, and welcome to today's Chrissy B Show. And we are, of course, the program that looks after your mental health and well-being. Well, this is one of life's biggest struggles, achieving that career. It's often a rocky journey and it takes an awful lot of work, something my guest tonight knows a lot about. Vikki Coombes worked across 5 different careers in 20 jobs until she set up her own business, Your Bright Horizons. Vikki will be sharing her emotional and physical journey with us, as well as giving her tips to those who might be struggling in different careers. And of course, it's also makeover day, so she'll be getting a full makeover courtesy of Sanni Sorma, who'll also be giving me her top tips for acne-prone skin. We'll also be getting a fun demonstration from Jar and Fern on how to create your own terrarium, and later on we'll be getting a new workout from fitness trainer Feyi Jegede. Then at the end of the show, I'll be telling you how I keep sight of my goals. Now, career change is an interesting topic. Believe it or not, around half of all UK workers want to change careers, with London's workers the unhappiest of them all. According to research by the London School of Business and Finance, 47% of men and women want to change jobs, and more than 1 in 5 will look into career hop in the next 12 months. Why? Well, of course, an increase in salary is a big reason, as well as better work-life balance and improved job satisfaction. Around a quarter say they made a mistake entering their current profession, but often the deciding factor in them not leaving their job is down to financial worries. Well, how are you getting on with your career moves? We checked Twitter to find out. Sam says, I'm worried about my career and my future, too much that I'm always stressed and always have anxiety. DJ Luna says, fall in love with something healthy, whether it be a hobby, a career, a ritual, an art, or a person. Michelle Epps quotes the television executive Nina Tesla saying, I had to reset my career GPS based on the opportunities I was afforded. There was no direct path. Lindsay says she's getting to that point in the school year where I question my life goals, education, career path, life decisions, sanity, etc. Sarah says, I've literally just had to give a flat viewing like an estate agent for my flat because the person didn't turn up. Definitely a new career path. Clara has a new obstacle in her life. She says, when I switched to a more traditional career, I never dreamed the sheer range and quantity of post-it notes my daily life would now include. So we'll be getting some advice on career paths with Vikki Coombes later, but before all of that, let's take a look at her makeover. Here's how she looked before, and here she is now. And doesn't she look lovely? Welcome to the show, Vikki.
Thank you, Chrissy.
Did you enjoy your makeover?
I had a great time.
Thank you so much, Sanni, for doing this.
You are very welcome. We had a great time.
Did you?
Yes, we did.
Good. So tell me what you think of this makeover.
I really like it because it's a little bit dramatic for me, but it's still quite natural.
Yes.
So it's not trying to make me into someone I'm not.
So is it quite different to what you normally do then?
Well, yes.
What's your normal makeup routine then?
I put moisturiser on when I get out of the shower, and that's it.
That's it.
Okay. That end.
So quite different, but you look amazing, my darling.
Yeah, thank you.
Now, we're actually going to be hearing your story a bit later on, so I'm going to say bye to you now and then hello again to you later, because you're going to be telling us all about your business and what you do, and also you're going to be giving some tips to our viewers as well.
Yeah.
Really, so join us right after this, guys. So, Sanni, what are your tips for today then?
So we are going to talk about makeup for acne-prone skin.
Okay.
And specifically kind of how to do your makeup, what kind of products to use, and also how to prep. Very important.
Right. Okay. Take it away,
Sanni. I love that. So number one is always like start with a clean canvas. So always have clean skin, use quite a gentle cleanser, and clean hands. So sanitize, even if you washed your hands, sanitize your hands, because acne and bacteria, it's not a good combo. So always make sure, and your brush is clean. Everything needs to be.
It smells lovely,
clean.
What is that?
Okay. It's lavender hand sanitizer, it's really good. And then also, a lot of the time, you will have kind of a tendency to overcover everything. If you've got acne and if your skin is not looking great, the tendency is to cover too much. And I'm kind of urging not to go down that route. To potentially, like, my favorite thing is to mix your moisturizer with foundation. So thin it out a bit, or use a tinted moisturizer. And first do that all over your face. And the type of moisturizers that I would use are unscented, unfragranced, very, very hypoallergenic, nothing scented. And so you do your first layer with that, and then you can kind of get your skin to an even tone, and then you start identifying where you need to cover a little bit more.
Okay.
So my absolute favorite product for acne prone skin is you can get these Vichy products from Boots, and this is Dermablend, and this is actually a foundation. However, I use it as a spot concealer after that foundation thing. So I'll show you what I do.
How did you come across these things and know you? Did you just sit there experimenting all
day? I experiment a lot.
A lot, okay.
I've got a little lab at home. But what I do is I put a little bit on my hand, I take my brush, this is a fluffy brush, and then pretending that this is my skin, my cheek, or wherever I have acne, I just literally buff it in like this.
Okay, so you're not caking it on, you're just doing it very gently. Okay.
And if you've got a slightly larger area with acne, because this is foundation, but it covers really well, you're just putting a super, super light coating of it. And also, so if you use foundation, concealer brushes, kind of like this, flat ones, you tend to put on a big layer, and also you tend to have a really kind of, like an outline around it. Whereas if you use a fluffy brush, there's no outline. Okay. It just kind of blurs it in really well. And then you always, always set with powder. So a very light dusting of powder is really good. Mm-hmm. And speaking of brushes, you gotta keep these babies clean. We did an episode a month or two ago about cleaning makeup
brushes. Your brushes.
Keep them clean. If you have acne, I would almost, well, not after every use, but every couple of uses, I would just give them a quick wash. It's super important. Mineral makeup is another really, really great tip. I've got two mineral products with me. This one is a blush. So acne people often, because you get a redder undertone, a little bit. So people tend to stay away from blush. I wouldn't say stay away from it. Use it very sparingly. And here, keep your blush kind of like quite high up on the face, so you're not actually putting red on top of red. And when you're using a mineral based blush, this is Bare Minerals, absolutely lovely products.
I love Bare Minerals.
They are so good, and they're all natural and vegan and all of that. And they are not going to clog your pores. Okay. So your pores are going to be happy.
Happy pores.
Happy pores. Yeah. You can also, if you're feeling brave, you can also go mineral makeup for the foundation. Mm-hmm. Now, they can be a little bit trickier to use because the tendency with these is to really kind of, I'll show you, because it's like, I'm sure that you ladies all know what mineral makeup looks like. This is powder, so the tendency is to think that, oh, I can put it on as much as I like. They can look just as cakey.
It's true, yeah.
Like, look really, really cakey. So what I do is I put the tiniest bit on the lid, like literally a tiny, tiny bit. And then again, with a small brush, not the whole face, small brush, tap all the excess off. They actually do this in the Bare Minerals, like QVC ad.
I know, I do the same thing, I love it.
And then you go round, but again, don't cake it on. This is powder, but it's still makeup, so it will look just as cakey. But the benefit of it is, it mineral makeup is really good for acne-prone skin, so it's gonna be.
So it's funny, you'd think that people mainly go for the other kind of foundation and stuff, but it kind of makes
this,
sense.
This does cover really well, and it won't aggravate anything. But like, I think that most people will be really familiar with my last tip, is when you feel bad about your skin, you kind of want to cover it up, but the idea is often with makeup is like draw attention to the parts that you want to bring out. So if your skin is not looking great and you're not feeling great, concentrate in the eyes. Do an amazing smoky eye, like draw everybody's eyes in. Put on some fake lashes if you feel like it. If you're feeling adventurous, we need to do a segment about fake lashes at some point. Putting them on, I'll put some on you.
Nope,
she doesn't like them. Or like a really bright lip. So if you're feeling, you know, go super red, go pink, do something that draws the attention away from the skin. And also, ideally, take the hair, like hair away from the face. So hair products or natural oils in the hair, because when they fall on your face, that's gonna make the problem worse again.
Okay, Sanni, thank you so much, my darling. And
we'll
see you again
welcome.
Very soon.
I hope so.
All right. Okay guys, so now it's time to speak to Nico Noviello for some hair tips. Welcome to the show, Nico.
Hey, thank you so much.
Fresh back from Italy?
Yes, just landed last night. Okay. I'm still recovering, but I'm good.
Thanks for coming on today.
Pleasure.
So what are you going to be telling us today?
Well, today I'm gonna be talking about just a few tips about hairstyle for this spring 2017. I was back in Italy and I've been working with such amazing people and such amazing hair, Italian hair. And they were quite an inspiration for me. And again, in this summer, we're gonna see lots of natural look, and especially with the people that they got no time to style the hair every day. So they just wanna do a quick blow dry and maintaining quite healthy hair texture, hairstyle. So basically, one of my tip is to kind of again wash your hair throughout with very good products, and use less product and just dry with a gentle heat, not too much, because like this you will protect the texture. And we know that now nowadays the water sometimes can ruin the hair, and because of the minerals that come through the sink, they can make your hair quite dry. Therefore, I would suggest use good products, and then use a little bit of heat, not too hot, and just try to use, you know, a good serum, and to not make them frizzy if you have quite a frizzy hair. And then also, you know, just put the hair, you know, in a ponytail if you're going to work, or just try to bring them down, and you know, make it very easy, simple look. It's always nice. I've been working with this beautiful model in Ravello last week, and she had such amazing hair, but she was using straightening iron every single day.
Oh, wow.
So the ends of the hair were quite dry. And I just basically did a very simple wrap dry, and then I just been using a little bit of product to protect
the
hair.
What do you mean
wrap dry? Just with a hair dryer, with a low speed and not too hot. And then using no brush, using fingers through the hair, because also, you know, nowadays we are kind of go to the hairdresser. We wanna have a glamour blow dries with the brushes that they sometimes hide your real texture. When we use fingers, just tap the fingers into your scalp and gently move. You know, throughout your head, we're gonna maintain your texture. Like this, we're gonna see a natural look instead of going through with the brush and pulling the hair. Sometimes, we know when we go to the hairdresser, we pull the hair too much. Your hair is gonna break, and eventually, we need to go back to use, you know, like elasticizer to bring it back, the elasticity of your hair. So what is important is to kind of just go through with your fingers, and you like this, you will maintain, you know, a natural look.
And should it fully be dry like that?
Well, I would definitely probably wrap dry for 70%.
Okay.
And then you're just gonna leave it to dry naturally.
Okay,
and it definitely will help. I definitely recommend this. I was working with this with my model last week in Ravello, and she did. We did exactly the same technique, and it looked really nice, as you can see from the pictures. And you know, again, also I was styling my. My friend's PR hair, she has extension. I just want to say hi to her, Francesca Fiore. She had amazing look, and I just basically been looking after hair, not heat at all.
Wow.
Just with the fingers, using less product, it always works. So
I
definitely recommend.
It's so much better for our hair, isn't it?
Definitely.
I'll be trying that, definitely.
Try, and I'm sure you're gonna
be I'll send you a picture.
Good. Please
All
do
right.
that.
Nico, thank you so much.
Pleasure.
And we'll see
thank you
again very soon.
Thank you.
Okay. All right, guys. So we're going to have more for you after the break. Now, nature, it's scientifically proven to improve our mental health. But do you get enough of it? Well, tune in after the break to see how you can make your home that little bit greener with the help of a terrarium.
back to the Chrissy B Show, everyone. Now, do you get enough greenery in your life? It can be difficult when living in the city. No garden to plant in, no ledge for a window box. Well, there are other ways to get your nature fix, as my next guests are about to show me. We have Will and Madeline with us.
Hey.
Hello. And we have also the lovely Julianne, who's also going to be doing the demo with us. And you actually the founders of Jar and Fern.
Yeah.
Can you tell us about that, please?
Yeah, we started about a year and a half, 2 years ago now. Yeah. I was actually trying to make a gift for Madeline, terrarium, because she had told me she was interested in them.
Okay.
But I wasn't a garden expert at that point.
Okay.
Mads is a plant expert, and so I got her to help me make her own gift.
Oh,
yeah. Which is actually better for me, really.
Oh, okay.
Yeah,
I just wanted to make sure it was like.
Yeah. Yeah. Okay. But we ended up having to go to about 5 different shops to buy all the different bits. We had to go to like a pet store, 2 garden centres, a homeware store, because it's not really easy to get the bits.
Yeah.
So we ended up making quite a few of them, because all the stuff left over for our friends and family gave them as gifts as well. And we got it in from there, really.
Started,
they all gave us good feedback, and then we started selling them.
So what actually is a terrarium?
Terrarium is the name for the type of vessel we use. So it's like a glass jar, which is either sealed or unsealed for storing plants in.
Okay.
We actually like the sealed ones more, because they have this really unique feature of being self-watering. Mm-hmm. So like if you have a lid on like this, it means any water that's in it will get kind of trapped in, and you have a water cycle from the evaporation and the condensation.
Yeah, it's really great because it means you don't actually have to water them, so they kind of almost look after themselves once you've got them in the right spot.
Cool. So great if you're going away on holiday or
Or
if you're really forgetful.
Yeah, if you're really forgetful. Have you killed a few plants, Julia?
No, I'm very good with my plants.
Oh, okay.
I'm very good.
Like, I do have to ask you that. How on earth did you get those plants in that jar with such a small spinning there? Yeah.
These ones are a bit more difficult. We're going to be doing a simple version today to start off with, but these ones, we need funnels to get the stones and the soil in.
Okay.
And then Mads has made...
We use little tools with like chopsticks with corks on the end or bent paintbrushes and things, And we put the plants in when they're quite small, so you kind of fold it up a little bit to go into the neck of the bottle.
That's amazing. Yeah. So I was looking for like an opening somewhere that kind of like a secret thing, but I couldn't see one. Now, just a question before we actually start doing this, because we're so excited.
Yeah. Cannot wait.
Why is something like this good for people to do?
I think, especially if you're living in London, there's not many opportunities to interact with the environment and especially gardening. No one has gardens really anymore. People live in flats and don't have much space. So I think it's a really good way just to interact with nature, first of all.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. Also, when we've had people, hopefully you'll find this when you do it yourself, people always tell us it's very relaxing and you have this weird kind of feeling. When you're just concentrating on like a small task like this with all your attention on these small details for a period of time, you get into this kind of state of flow where you're not really thinking about the past or the present. You're just kind of
just focused
really
on
in the present. Yeah, right now.
It's really relaxing. You kind of like forget about any of your worries. You focus on what you're doing. And also people really enjoy picking the colours and the different sizes of plants and things, making a little mini landscape in there. So.
Oh, lovely. Well, I'm looking forward to it. Should we get started?
Yeah,
that
you have to talk
good.
Us through, because I've never done this before. Have you done this before?
No.
Brilliant? No.
Might end up doing like more after this.
It gets really addictive, honestly. Like my flat is full.
Is it?
My landlady is not going to be happy.
She's not watching, it's fine.
So the first thing we're going to do is add some of the stones over here, and there's some spoons if you want to use them, or you can use your hands.
I can use my hands, I'm not getting dirty. All right.
So you just add a couple of inches in the base of your jar.
Okay.
And this is really good for drainage as well, so it means if there's any water in the jars, it won't sit on the roots of the plant.
Sorry for the noise, guys. Let me move my jar over here, Julian, so you've got access. Here you go.
Okay.
We should do a race, but we won't. Not today.
Let's not get competitive, not just yet.
Is that enough?
A little bit more. You want just a few inches so you can kind of see the layer in the base.
Okay.
Do you have like a preference?
Yeah, that's good on that.
Do you have a preference when it comes to stones and stuff?
So we use these ones in this jar because it's a smaller size, so there's more potential for the water getting stuck. But you can also use the smaller gravel like in this one here.
Yeah.
And we'll use that for topping in this one.
Yeah.
These are just like beach stones from the garden centres.
Okay. Do I have enough?
Yeah, that's perfect.
Yeah,
okay. Yeah, that looks great. So the next thing is just to add a spoon of this stuff here, which is called activated carbon.
What does
It's really, really absorbent, so it can absorb up to 200 times its own weight in organic matter. So
if
a leaf falls off and dies or there's a bad smell in there, that'll soak
that
up.
That's cool.
It's what they use, you know, Brita water filters?
Yeah.
It's the active ingredient in that because it sucks out toxins from the water.
Oh, cool.
Yeah.
Can you use this in cat litter? Just
I've heard people use it in their fridge if they want to take out smells and stuff. It's really good for absorbing odors.
And aquariums as well.
Okay.
So maybe.
Okay. And apparently you can also use it as a, what's it called, like a face cleanser?
A face mask, or you can brush your teeth with it as well.
I've heard about that.
Wow.
Yeah.
Okay.
So on top of there, you're adding some of this soil, which is indoor plant compost. And you can tell it is because of the little white flecks in there.
Yeah.
So you want about as much soil as you've got stones. So straight on top.
If you don't want to get your hands to do that, you can use that as well, but it's totally up to you.
I'm getting my hands.
Yeah, okay.
Go on in. It's all right, it's all right.
Yeah, something okay, I'm we're posh. Teaching people is they love like touching soil and the plants and things because you don't get much chance to do that usually. Yeah.
Yeah. Well, I would, but I've got the rest of the show to do, so I'm going to
make it. Yeah.
You kind of just level it out, yeah?
Yeah.
Yeah.
This is fun, isn't it?
I can see what you mean. I'm already in the zone.
Yeah.
This is so okay. Relaxing.
I think I've got enough there.
Okay, just one more spoon.
I do one more spoon.
One
yeah.
More? Okay.
Yeah.
Is that around?
Look, just one more as well for you, I think.
Not even keeping an eye on the time. Look at me, I'm just so focused on this, I forgot we have a timer.
And then when you've got your soil in there, you want to make a little bit of a well in the centre, so you've got a space to drop your plants into. Right. If you want to just pass the bowl, actually, we'll split the plants into there.
Okay. Do you want to dig that well?
Until you touch the stones, okay. Yeah, that's fine. Yeah, that's
got
great.
It. All right, cool. Oh, sorry.
So the next bit is we're going to decide what plants you're going to put in there.
Okay.
We've got these two here today. Both of them are called Fittonia, or nerve plant, and you can see by the little veins on the leaves.
Yeah.
And these are lots of small plants in there. Okay. So you want two of these going in there. So okay. If you want to have a go at splitting
which one
it.
Which one do you
want? Yeah. The red.
Cool, because I really want
you guys can mix and match as well.
Oh, can we? Okay.
So just give the pot a little bit of a squeeze, and you'll feel the plant kind of come out, and then the little plants are in there.
Okay.
And then you want to just separate them. They will fall apart quite easily. Yeah, that's perfect.
Ooh. How many do we take?
If you just want a couple, yeah. Okay. You can use both colours if you want or just one.
Okay.
Hang on. And you want to shake off as much of that soil as possible, right. Yeah.
Oh, this is messy, isn't it? Don't care anyone, I've got my fingers dirty, that's fine. We can use a couple each.
Okay, here. Here's okay. Some pretty ones. They're all pretty.
I'm going to take one more red one.
Okay. So they go into the well in the centre, so if you want to get them in there.
Oh gosh, this is...
Yeah, all right, let's try. Might have a struggle with three, because it'll take up quite a bit of space.
You know what, I'm just going to stick these in.
Maybe do, if you take maybe one less, because that's quite a big one. Yeah, you don't want to overcrowd.
Don't be greedy, Julianne.
They're so pretty, I want all of them. Okay, all right.
Yeah, that's great. And when you've got them in there, you want to bed the soil, bed them down a little bit.
My hands don't fit in there. I've got quite big hands, you know. Like, I don't want to see.
You can always use the spoon.
My
as well,
sort of just like, there. Okay, let me try and use the spoon.
Is it okay if I scatter whilst I scatter?
What do you mean with the plants?
Yeah. So like, add more soil.
Yeah, that's fine. Yeah, if you want to stand them up. Yeah.
My one's not standing up. Hang on.
Leaning a little bit. You might want to just put them down a little bit further.
Is that right?
That's looking pretty good.
Yeah? Okay.
It doesn't matter if they're not in like really tight yet, because you can add some rocks at the end.
Oh, okay.
It.
All right then.
Yeah.
All right. Mine's just taking a nap for the time being. Yeah.
I like
thank
where you
Will.
Put yours. Yeah.
I didn't mean to. I was trying to get the centre, but it's
like... Yeah, you want them quite central, because if the leaves really press up against the glass, they can rot a bit. So it's good
see.
To keep them as far in the middle.
Mine's definitely leaning.
That's all right, we can stand them up.
So cool.
Then we'll add a little bit of ivy. So if you want to have a go at splitting that as well, it's a bit more difficult, so the roots are usually a bit more tangled.
I'm sorry, plants.
Ivy's not going to try and escape and go everywhere.
It gets tall in there, but you can just trim it.
Okay, all right.
Top, so,
Imagine waking up next day, it's like boom, everywhere.
You want to pick the really small ones, so.
So about the size?
Yeah, the little one's great.
Yeah.
And again, like take off the soil.
Okey-dokey.
And that can touch the sides, so you want to, if you make a little hole for it again.
Oh, right, okay. I was trying to work that one out.
So do you get people that come in here that are constantly stressed out? And like, what sorts of people do you get, like, building terrariums?
I think people like to do it on, it's kind of a different activity as well, isn't it, on the weekend, like, rather than just going to the pub or whatever, you're learning a new skill and socialise and stuff.
Yeah.
People often
make
friends.
We've had all sorts of people. We had a kid come along with his mum that was 7 years old.
Yeah.
And he'd actually like done all the research on YouTube before and knew exactly what he was doing. Like, we didn't need to teach him at all, he just grabbed all the plants.
Oh, bless.
Yeah, he knew exactly what he wanted it to look didn't he?
Actually, much older people as well. So
I was going to say, this is like the perfect family activity.
It is. Yeah. Imagine, you've got enough sure question. Yes. Do you still have the terrarium that you were given?
I do.
Yeah, do you?
And it's still alive, isn't it?
Yeah, still going.
Oh, that's so sweet. How old is it now?
It's a year and a half now.
Oh, thank you. Okie dokie.
So if you've got those in there, The next thing we're going to do is add a little bit of moss to the surface. So if they are leaning, you can use the moss to hold them up a little bit. So there's a bit for you. You can break it into smaller pieces.
That's right.
I need help.
It's doing well.
Yeah, so like a little bit like that or there. That's okay, a good one.
Right, cool.
And you bed that into the soil again as well on the surface.
The roots of stones at the end as well.
Okay, because this is kind of like smacking cool. on the side of the thing.
All right. Yeah, so that's a perfect little bit there.
Right.
And then you kind of bed that down into the soil so you can't see the brown roots anymore.
There we go, baby.
There you go, baby.
They're fragile.
You're going to get attached to this, aren't you? Can I take a bit more moss?
We always notice people name their terrariums as soon as they make them as well.
Oh, okay.
We always give them a name, I don't know.
This is Trevor the terrarium.
Yeah. Oh, I don't know what to call my Tatiana.
Oh, there we go. Tatiana and Trevor. Terrariums forever.
Yeah.
Okay. So maybe you could use that bit to just hold them up a little bit.
Are we supposed to make a hole for the moss, by the way?
No, you can just kind of just push it down if the soil's loose. As long as you can't see the brown roots and they're in, that's fine.
Okay.
Yeah.
Oh, that looks so cute.
If I don't say so myself.
You're doing really well. I'm not doing well at all. Like, this is just...
No, it's good.
Okay.
I used to help my dad in the garden, that's why.
We didn't have gardens growing up.
Oh, sorry.
That makes it so sad. No, it's fine, it's fine.
That's good. Just, if you get that little light brown bit out, pick it out.
Okay, there we go. You know what, you're there.
Oh, forgetting to look at the timer again. We've got about a minute and a half left.
Okay,
right,
okay.
We're almost done, so not much more. So if
sorry guys,
with...
I forgot all about our viewers.
That's the thing though, you really get in the flow with
it.
So if you're happy with how much moss, the last thing to do is just add some of these little pebbles on the surface. And you kind of want to cover most of the soil because that holds it down when the water cycle starts.
All right.
So just a little sprinkle of these in the gaps.
Thank you.
Okay.
Yeah.
Thank you. Oh, that's gone over there.
And once you seal these, the water cycle will start, so you don't need to water it or anything. There's enough water in the plants and soil already.
Okay. If it's going all over the moss, though, is that not a good thing?
It's okay. There's some paintbrushes to just dust it off afterwards.
Oh, okay. So. All right, cool.
Yeah.
Now we get ready.
Yeah.
This is so much fun. Okay. But I made a bit of a mess, but it's not too bad. Do you want me to
that's
pour
okay,
it
don't
in
worry.
You...
I think I've got enough here now. Oh, no, I'm just going to few here.
I'm going to pour it all over the plant.
No, I'm just, I think...
this is like, I'm usually so precise with things.
I don't think my moss is actually attached to the thing. All right. Okay, I highly recommend this activity for our viewers at home. I've loved it.
I've loved it
And look at the beautiful masterpieces that we have. So then you just like, would you water this straight away, guys?
You don't need to water it at all. There's enough in there. So.
Yeah, but how often would you do it?
Maybe after 6 months, you need to add some more water. So,
Serious?
Yeah. There's lots in the plant and the soil already.
And you always leave the lid on?
Yeah, so if you can, it doesn't matter too much if you don't remember, but maybe like once a month, leave it open for an hour or two. Just lets the air in it come and like refresh a little bit.
Oh, wow. I love it. Guys, look at that. Thank you so
it's
much.
Beautiful. You're welcome.
Thank you so much. I really love doing this. Definitely try this at home, guys. I love it. And you do workshops as well?
Yeah, all over London. So.
Okay,
yeah.
All right. Brilliant.
You can get involved.
Thank you so much. Juliana, are you happy, my darling?
I am so happy. Look at this. Yes.
Okay.
You can come around to want to make one of these next time.
Oh, yes, definitely. That one is the challenge. I want to try that one, definitely. Well, thanks so much.
You're welcome. Thank you for having me.
Thank you.
All right, guys, so stay tuned because after the break, I'll be speaking to Vikki Coombes.
Hi, I'm Chrissy B and my show is all about improving your mental health and being happy. Join me every Monday, Wednesday and Friday at 10 p.m. on my channel Sky 203. Visit chrissybshow.tv for more information and subscribe to our YouTube channel Chrissy B Show. You can also follow us on Twitter and Instagram at Chrissy B Show and on our Facebook page, The Chrissy B Show. Welcome back to the Chrissy B Show. So today we've given the lovely Vikki a makeover courtesy of Sanni Sorma, and now it's time to settle down and hear her personal story. Hello again, Vikki.
Hello, Chrissy.
So you've got quite a bit to your story, but first of all, can you tell us about Your Bright Horizons, which is the business that you set up?
So Your Bright Horizons is a learning, coaching and consulting organisation, I suppose. Mm-hmm. And we partner with people to live their life to the fullest.
Okay.
And so I set it up about a year ago, just over a year ago.
Okay. And what was the reason behind that? What had you been through personally that made you think, you know, this is a good thing to do?
So I'd spent I was a management consultant in the corporate world, and I had got to that point where I kind of felt really stagnant. I'd slowed down, everything had not died, but I was just, I was feeling quite miserable, and I knew I needed to do something different.
Did you know at that point what you wanted to do?
Not really. Okay. Well, I did kind of, well, when I left work, I decided what I was going to do was make money.
Okay. That's a good goal, yeah.
Yeah, I was going to make money. Yes. But it took me not very long to realise I've never been motivated by money.
Okay.
So it wasn't particularly successful to try and just go out and make money. Okay. There had to be something more to it than that, and that's where the Your Bright Horizons evolved from, was it had to be meaningful. There had to be something about it that made an impact on other people.
Okay.
And then the making money out of that is fine. It's just there needs to be something that matters about it.
Okay. Now tell us, that you describe some people as hummingbirds. Can you tell us what that is?
So I'm the queen of hummingbirds. Well, I like to say that, right? Mainly because I like tiaras. But hummingbirds for me are the people who pursue their curiosity, so wherever that might take them, which usually means that they've had lots of different jobs.
Yeah.
So for instance, I've had about 20 jobs over 5 careers. So, they're often those people. They've usually moved quite a lot. They'll have a lot of different hobbies. Mm-hmm. So they'll be really into something. So for instance, I have been really into steampunk, and I'll be really into it for a period of time, and then you move on to something else. So lots of different hobbies. And then the people that are often told by others, you need to settle down, you need to make a choice. And and actually, when someone says that to us, we kind of go, because we don't want to. It's not who we are. But we live in this world where that's what we're told to do. That you need to, particularly in a career, choose a career.
Yeah.
Follow that career. That's what we're told. And so if that's not your natural way of being, and actually when you try and do that, you end up like I did, very stagnant, very miserable with it.
Okay.
And then that can lead to depression and all sorts of things. So so for me, hummingbirds, that's who they are, and it's about actually the lives we lead are really fascinating because they're constantly bringing different things into the world,
Just a question, Vikki, though, but how did you actually come to that conclusion? Because obviously you realised that you didn't like just one thing and your likes changed over a period of time, but when did you actually come to the conclusion that, well, actually, it's okay to be like this and it's okay to like lots of different things and to move on from things and actually I'm going to do something with that? What was that kind of turning point for you?
That happened, for me, it personally happened quite a long time ago. I became, and part of that is because my background in management consulting is people and change, right? And I got into that because of change, and change has always been a core part of my life, and so I've always been quite comfortable with it for myself.
Yeah.
What I came to the understanding of last year was actually that my business could be about who I am rather than about what I am.
Mm-hmm.
And then as I started discovering and talking to other people who also are hummingbirds, I discovered that that's when, for a lot of people, there are these key challenges about feeling there's something wrong with them or they don't fit in. And so when I started listening to people's stories, I could see myself as a teenager or in my early 20s. Okay. But because of some of the stuff I went through personally at those ages myself, I'd moved through that.
Okay.
So I sat there and went, well, I can help you, right? I've done this.
Okay.
So rather than you trying to work it out, let me help you work it out.
Okay, right. And what kind of impact is that having on people's lives, just say?
So I just love it because people suddenly go, oh my God. Yeah. There's that kind of relief of I'm actually all right.
Yeah.
And actually what you're saying to me is it's not just that I'm all right, you're actually saying to me I'm amazing.
Mm-hmm.
And I'm like, yeah, you are. We had a party last night and probably half the room were hummingbirds. And there was no one in that room that you'd stand and have a conversation with them and everyone had something interesting to talk about because they've just led such varied lives, and I just find people kind of go, oh, and then they go, okay, but now what do I do with that, right? And so it's things like really practical things, like how do you do a CV? And I'm like, well, let's think about, let's not call it a CV. Let's call it so in consulting we call it pen portrait.
Mm-hmm.
Oh, what's that? I'm like, that's 5 bullet points, that's about you. And and it's about you putting yourself forward for what you want to do, not a chronological history that other people go, I don't get your chronological history.
Yeah.
So
it makes sense, doesn't it? It's quite a lot. Yeah, I can see why they would need help in certain things. So that's really good.
Yeah, and it's just some quite practical things that I've learned to do along the way that I'm kind of like, oh, well, actually, this is really quite simple. But because they've never been in that environment themselves, they don't know how to do it. So it's that kind of.
Okay, and what's the future for your Bright Horizons, Vikki? Where do you see it going?
Wow. So being a hummingbird, of course, your Bright Horizons isn't just about one thing.
Of course.
So there's definitely the program for hummingbirds, and we've got courses, and we've got coaching, and we are looking to do a retreat. But also one of the things I've become interested in most recently is multiple braining. So I'm going to be training coaches and how to use multiple braining with their clients. Mm-hmm. And then I'm also, we're also working in collaboration with another organisation for Phenomenal Women. So I'm, I'm making sure that I'm keeping myself interested.
Oh, definitely. Yeah. Brilliant. Vikki, thank you so much for coming on to speak to us today.
Thanks, Chrissy.
And telling us that it's okay to be a hummingbird. I'm one, by the way, I have to say. Definitely.
Yes, you are.
Thank you, my darling, and all the best for everything you're doing.
Thank you very much.
Well, guys, we do have more for you before the break. Now, nothing gets us more comfortable to talk about our experiences than good hospitality. And more often than not, good hospitality comes hand in hand with good food. Let's see how Pax Brown got on when he visited the Italian pasta house, Pasta Renoli.
Ladies and gents, today I'm right behind Finsbury Park Station, next to the Park Theatre, and I'm very excited to be trying some typical Italian, very rustic food. Let's go and check it out. Hello.
Hello.
Hello, you're Simone.
Yes.
Hi, nice to meet you. How's
it going? Nice to meet you. All good. And you?
Well, thank you for having us today.
Good.
So, as we can see here, we've got a nice, lovely selection of pasta.
That's what we do. That's what we're famous for. Our fresh pasta is one of the best in London at the moment. And we're producing here every day, fresh. All the ingredients is coming from Italy, and it's great. People love it.
So obviously we want to sample a dish today. Yep. What would you suggest?
Well, today what we're gonna try, one of my favorites, which is a pappardelle with the Italian pork sausage ragu and the oxtail agnolotti.
Could you explain to us a bit about the pasta that you make here? What's the ethic? What's the kind of process you go through? How does it work?
I understand the beauty of this product many years before with my grandmother, when she was doing pasta for all the family. But in London, I saw the opportunity of a product like this to go in the market as a fast casual dining product. In the beginning, the menu was free pastas, meat pastas, and free vegetarian, that's all. But then we start to develop and we start to see the market. We come up with this beautiful concept that basically is the homemade pasta, homemade sauces. You choose the pasta, you choose the sauce, you choose the cheese to get it on top. You can buy the pasta and the sauce, you can eat in here in our restaurant, you can take away cooked, or you can have a cook-at-home option, which I call the pastificio option, which is basically you can buy the pasta raw, you can buy the sauce, you can buy the cheese, 3 minutes, you can cook in your house, you can share it with your family and friends, you can pretend you cook by yourself.
Wow, who would have said that fresh, traditional, rustic, homemade pasta could be fast food and also essentially better than a ready meal and quicker than a ready meal as well. That's absolutely amazing. Well, I can't wait to try the food now.
Yeah, now it's coming the starter.
Beautiful, thank you very much.
So that's burrata with Parma ham. Burrata is basically coming from Puglia and is a kind of a buffalo mozzarella, but it's made with cow milk. And then we have our focaccia and our bread, which is homemade, and olive oil from Puglia.
Amazing. So this burrata, does that mean that once I cut it in, it will sort of explode into a creamy?
It's basically, as you can
Let's
see.
Have a look. Wow.
So inside, you see?
So you use very basic seasoning like olive oil, pepper, salt, just to elevate those simple tastes. Me too, yeah. I'm gonna just. So what do we have here? Sorry.
Pappardelle with Italian pork sausage. Basically, the sausage is made in Tuscany. So it's a proper fennel and salt and pepper sausages. And then we got the oxtail agnolotti. Agnolotti is a funny name that we said for a kind of a ravioli. So it's a filled pasta. It's inside there is an oxtail. And on top, for both dishes, we always suggest pecorino romano, which is a little bit more salty. It brings up the full flavor of the dish.
Brilliant. Well, shall we try then? Without further ado, yes, let's give it a try because I can't wait. Right, admittedly, guys, this is one of the best pasta dishes I have ever had. The balance is perfect. The way the pasta is cooked is spot on. The filling is just so flavorsome. So thank you so much, Simone.
It's made with passion. And when you make your food with passion, you cannot fail.
It's absolutely lovely. Without trying to sound rude, I'm going to put the microphone on the side now and just enjoy the pasta, if you don't mind, yeah?
Enjoy, guys, okay? Thank you so much.
Thank you very much. Thank you.
Grazie. Well, guys, in true Italian style, I'm having a little espresso coffee after my lunch. Now, remember, it's always great for your mental health and well-being to try new things, visit new places, and of course, Pasta Remoli is just one of them, so do check it out. Till later, guys.
Thank you very much to Pax Brown and to Pasta Remoli. Now, do you feel like you're losing sight of your goals in life? Well, if so, stay tuned for my own tips on how I keep sight of my goals. And we'll also be getting some great workout tips for your gorgeous pins from Feyi Jegede. Welcome back to the Chrissy B Show, everyone. Now, we all know the massive benefits of exercise, both for mental and physical health, and we're always looking for new and exciting workouts for you to do at home. So here, fitness trainer Feyi Jegede gives us some top workout moves for you to do with your legs.
Hey there, guys. Thank you so much for joining me in today's fitness segment. Today, I have a great workout for you. We are going to be working our legs. This workout today is going to give you nice, toned, shapely legs because I'm going to be using traditional sculpting moves. You're going to need a mat, and let's get started. Now come down onto your mat and start off being on your knees, okay? So as you are on your knees, make sure you are your arms like hip-width apart, okay? Same with your knees as well. And we're just literally going to start with our right and our left. And what we're gonna do is we're gonna do something known as a doggy move. So we're gonna start from here, bring it straight up, keeping the feet flat, so the toes are flat, okay? So here we go, straight up. Now these exercises, as I said, are great for the legs, but they're also good for the glutes, the butt area. So you're getting double for your money. So keep going. Now I want you to do two sets of eight, so that's 16 in total. And then we'll move on to the second exercise. Just give me one more. Excellent. Hold it up there and we're gonna pulse. So we're gonna push up into the air. Ooh, my butt is feeling this. Excellent, and your butt's gonna feel it too. And there you have it. So now let's move on to the next exercise. Point those toes. Point your legs and you're gonna bring it down. So you're gonna cross it over like this. So you're gonna go up and then across. And the aim of this is to pretend that we're drawing a smile, okay? So it's gonna be like this and across. So here we go, from this height, bring it across. That's one, that's two, that's three. Make sure you keep your abs contracted, okay? So holding everything nice and tight. Excellent. Whew, I can feel this. Good, well done. So we're working a full range of motion and we're trying lots and lots of different exercises, okay? So lying down on your side, point your feet to one angle. So to the edge of your mat, okay? Once you've got that diagonally, you can rest on your elbow or you can rest on your hand. So pick which one's comfortable for you. And we're just gonna work our top leg. We're gonna bring it down and then up. This one is really hard because it's working the length of your legs, your hips as well. Good, reach up. If you're shaking, just lower the height a little bit, okay? And then build up when you're comfortable and more progressed. Keep going. Oh, I'm dying. It's a good thing this segment's not very long, isn't it? Well done, guys. Keep going. Four more. And three, two, breathe, and one. Excellent. So tap your glutes, because it's a toughie, okay? Bend your legs at that angle, and then we're literally going to lift it up and down. So I'm going to come down on my hands for this, and literally, it's because I feel like I need to have a lie down. No, I'm kidding. It's because sometimes I find it easier if I'm resting my head on my hand just to do this one, okay? And you're going to feel it right here in the glutes, the butt cheeks, okay? So just give me two more, and then one more. Remember at home, I want you to do how many? Two sets of eight. Excellent. Oh, thank you so much, guys, for joining me in today's workout. And I'll catch you again next week in another fitness segment. Bye-bye.
Thank you very much to Feyi. So now it's time for my own advice, I would say, on how I don't lose sight of my goals. And hopefully this will help you as well. So my first point is, I always have a good reason. And this is something very, very important. I have a big goal with the mental health work that I'm doing through this program and also through my writing. But I'll be honest with you, sometimes the going does get really tough. And there are days when it seems like nothing is happening and things just are stagnant and that those dreams are impossible to achieve. But I keep plowing on. Why is that? Because the reason behind my dream is so important. It affects so many lives. So that's what keeps me going. And actually, just recently, I went through one of those periods where everything seemed stuck. And then I won the Global Woman Award. So sometimes it seems things aren't moving, but as long as you're working hard and you're trying different things, things are actually happening in the background, even though if you can't see things straight away. My second way that I keep myself, you know, focused on my goal is I get organized. I make sure that I'm always organized. So I'm always trying to think of new systems, better ways of doing things, because I don't want to waste any time. And that includes things at home. So I'm always very organized at home as well. Like recently, for example, I've just had a massive clear out. Me and my hubby really got stuck into decluttering things. Things that I thought maybe I would need, but we've really been strict with ourselves and getting rid of things and giving away clothes. And things are so much easier for me to do now and to clean. It makes such a big difference. So once, you know, things like that are sorted out, you can actually focus better on your dreams and things that you have to do. My third point is to keep an open mind. So I like to try new things to reach my goals. So whether that's something with social media or maybe even a different segment on this program, I try things all with the aim of reaching my goal. So you may have noticed, if you've been a viewer for a while, we've been doing this show for 5 years now, you may have noticed that the program has evolved quite a bit and we're trying different things and we get feedback from you, our viewers. So it's good to actually try different things and keep an open mind and, you know, get even ask for people's opinion. I like to ask people's opinion about the program. I ask my friends, sometimes ask the camera crew, ask the people that I work with. And I always like an honest opinion, even though it might not be exactly what we want to hear sometimes. But it's good to get feedback from people so you can improve and reach your goals as well. My fourth point is to say no. And this is something that so many people have a problem doing. I really had to learn to do this. I used to feel so guilty if someone asked me for something and I didn't have time to do it. And I just used to say yes. I was known as the yes person because I always wanted to help everyone. But that started to affect me because I couldn't cope with everything. So then actually once another opportunity came up for me to do something quite big as well. And I weighed up everything really carefully and I'd really had to say no to that opportunity. Sometimes there are daily things that I have to say no to as well. And there are times when I feel like, you know, going out for a friend, something simple like going out somewhere, doing something. But if I know I haven't got time and there's other things to do that are more important, then I need to say no. Obviously, you're not going to always say no to things because there are opportunities that come. You need to kind of weigh which ones to go for and which not. And also you have to have your me time and time to rest. But just make sure you weigh things out properly and you're saying no to the right things. And don't waste time on silly things. My fifth point, which is something very important, is to surround yourself with positive people. I'll be really honest with you, I'm very selective with who I hang around with. I won't hang around with time wasters, with gossips, or with people that have no ambition in life. I'm willing to try and help these people in certain situations. Of course, that's what I do. I help people, I give people advice, but in terms of friendships, absolutely no way. And sometimes even your good, positive friends may say something unintentionally that doesn't actually help you. So I had this happen, some comments about, you know, someone made some comments about the show, but I knew they didn't understand my vision. So I just kept quiet and kind of rejected those words. It was like, she was trying to give me advice and try to, it wasn't anything to do with improving the program, but just something that was limited, something, my dream, for example, is up here, and this person was kind of trying to make me think down here in a sense. I can't really go into details, but even though her intentions were good, but in my mind, I was like, no, that's not what my goal is. My goal is different, and this is what I want to achieve through it. So you have to kind of know, you know, be careful who your friends are, but even your good friends that are positive, and anyone around you, or your family, people that care about you, sometimes they can make say certain things unintentionally, like that, to try to help you, but in fact that actually takes you away from your dream. So be very, very careful. Well, everyone, we have reached the end of today's program, but if you have anything that you would like to talk about on this program, maybe you'd like to be our next makeover guest, or maybe you know someone that deserves a makeover, maybe they've been through a hard time in life, or maybe they're not spending enough time on themselves and they're not really looking after themselves, do get in touch with us to nominate them. You can email us on info@chrissybshow.tv. You can also tweet us @chrissybshow or leave a message on our Facebook page, The Chrissy B Show. Until next time, bye-bye for now.
I've had a really good time. It was a lot of fun. Everybody was very welcoming. And I was really nervous when I started, but very relaxing, and just had a really joyful time.